a productive member of society next to the men.
Ma'am, just one last question. Of course, women's empowerment also comes through political empowerment.
Yes.
Are you hopeful one day Afghanistan will have a woman president too?
It does not need to be a woman president, you know. I mean, there are very good women that can be president and a very good man that could be president. And sometimes it's a question of destiny, who becomes a president and who doesn't. But I think I want women to be able to live their life fully. That's what I want. It's not, and they can live their life fully maybe if their ambition is to have a small business. Let it be. You know, if their ambition is to become a professor, let it be. If their ambition is to become a president, a minister, or a deputy, let it be. You know, let the woman decide what they want to be.
So let the woman decide is the key. It was such a privileged interaction with you. Ms. Kali, give her a round of applause. Possible. So here was, of course, the first lady of the Islamic Republic of Afghanistan with wonderful views, and she is like this breath of fresh air. Of course, that country has a lot to be proud about, and I'm sure that women in the years to come will make Afghanistan even more proud. If you have been watching the special broadcast on Headlines today, thanks a lot. News and updates continue right after the break.
Thank you, Excellency. I think what you said about mindset is the actual key word where we also have in India, and we are doing a lot from flow to change to that. May I now invite Vasu Bharatra, Flow Vice President, to give the word of time for the session.
Afghanistan conjures images of majestic mountains, trees laden with ripe fruit, and of course, Rabindranath Tagore's famous Kabuli Wala. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. India and Afghanistan have always shared a very close relationship of trust and cooperation. As one of India's closest neighbors, it is imperative that we work together for mutually beneficial development of our countries. In both our nations, encouraging women to take up livelihoods, be self-sustaining, is extremely important going forward. From this interaction, it is clear that issues related to women are the same across borders and all over the world. I hope that this is just the beginning of this dialogue, and we will have many more opportunities to interact and collaborate in time to come. It is indeed a privilege to have with us the Honorable Rula Ghani Ji, the First Lady of the Islamic Republic of Afghanistan. We are so grateful to you for taking out this time to be with us today, and for this enriching interaction. I would also like to thank His Excellency Ambassador Shahida Muhammad Abdali, Ambassador of the Islamic Republic of Afghanistan to India, and the delegation accompanying the Honorable First Lady, the Embassy of Afghanistan, and everyone who has joined us today and helped make this event possible. I'd like to congratulate Mrs. Archana Dhubey Gupta, President Flo, on a very successful first event. Wish you all the best for the coming year. Thank you to Mrs. Vasudha Soni, Flo member and our platinum sponsor for the year. Thank you for so generously hosting today's team. I'd like to thank our esteemed past presidents for their presence, encouragement and eternal support. And also the members of Flo who are present with us today. And last but not the least, I'd like to thank Dr. Manju Kalra Prakash and her team for working so tirelessly behind the scenes. Thank you all, and please join us for some refreshments.
Thank you, Padri. The First Lady has kindly agreed to a group picture, so can I request the past presidents and the GB members to please come up with the lights? Thank you.